Here's the fourth away from downtown Minneapolis. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell, and the Lions are going to take possession of the football. How big is that penalty? Wipe out the INT.
You'd hate to be the teammate that caused that penalty and wiped out the interception. You got to face that guy in the locker room. Not a lot of fun for you, and you hurt your squad.
Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football.
Wow, just one snap in, partner, and the complexion of this game has already changed because for the defensive side, they just handed their offense a short field and a big early advantage. And even though it's only the first snap of the game, we're going to look back on this one and see if it has lasting effects as this game moves on.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. Inside handoff, Henry, and he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down. Well, this defense, Charles, really played well in that win.
Performance, they did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher, third down and 9.
As a wideout, when you take that handoff and you're coming around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw on that play with a loss. He's going to air one out. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
The kick by Carlson is good. And the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. So the interception set up a terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
A gain of 3, second down. And CD, you look at this defense, you know, what kind of pressure are they under trying to stop a team that has won 5 games in a row?
Well, to me, it makes their job harder because you know you're going up against an offense that's playing at an elite level, and sometimes you can get too caught up in trying to play the perfect game. You're trying to be too precise, too fine, instead of just letting it rip. And I think that's more of a priority than trying to be absolutely perfect.
Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. Defense doing their job, really nowhere to run the football.
Yeah, it's almost textbook, wasn't it? Every place he tried to find an open spot, there just wasn't one. Congrats to the defense, no gain.
Call fitting your gaps, right?
I love it. You're exactly right.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Throwing on third, Goff. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell. And the Vikings are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line.
For a team who came in here on a healthy winning streak, we're seeing some uncharacteristic bad play that's recorded in strength. It's definitely in jeopardy with this offense. Keeps giving the ball away and can't mount a few drives of their own.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards. Second down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball.
On play action, they'll throw. And his throw is incomplete.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Now back to throw. They set up the screen for Henry. And to the 46 he goes and no further, so he is well short of the first down marker. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
And Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And you figure this should be a healthy, arrested, a focused unit, and they're working on a good winning streak. They had the week off last week. This is really a team. He's got daylight. The 40, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Detroit. One play, 80 yards. Pretty easy drive to recap.
It certainly is, but not so easy to execute. Starting on your own 20, you want something to kickstart your drive and get it off to a nice start. They went for the whole thing and got it. That's a great way to send a message to the opposing team.
Gano the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And, of course, this a critical game in regards to not just the division race, but playoff seeding as well. They are a game up, but a loss here could really muddy the waters.
And both these teams want to clear things up about how they feel about each other and their standing in the league. Because these two teams, they've really been the cream of the crop in their division. So this game, it's been looming on both of their schedules.
On second down, here's Henry. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Complete. It's Henry. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down.
But we know the guys up front have to protect when it's a pass play. But it's really out wide. Sometimes you're going to swing a tight end or maybe even offensive tackle to get out there. But most of the time, it's fellow wide receivers. And they really weren't up to the task there, were they?
What, do you like that call on your own side of the field?
I don't mind that call at all, just about anywhere. But the key is you have to have the confidence, and then they have to execute their blocking assignments. Otherwise, you get the end result we just saw there.
It's a 47-yard punt, but they did give up 10 on the return. And the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Running on first down, Eckler. And he lost the football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. And a little carry.
Completion.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Running left, it's Henry. And a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. 12 yards there, first down Vikings. For a lot of people, MVP award means the quarterback award usually, but over 100 yards again last week. They're going to have to look his way more than once when giving out this award this season, I think.
Yeah, it's not just the consistency. It's been some plays that we've seen where we talk about it for weeks thereafter. That's what we're getting out of him. Over 100 yards last week. Expects to continue that in this game, too.
A big play there for Minnesota. And even 40 yards.
That is the exact right play call against that defense. So a hat tip to the offensive play caller because he won that part of the chess match. But give credit to his players as well. They won the execution part of it.
Henry will take this into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. So the moment is finally at hand. What a season, CD. His 29th rushing touchdown of the year. No one in the history of the NFL has had more in a single season. And congratulations to him. What an achievement.
We certainly have a feeling early in the year, maybe week two or three, where we talked to each other and thought, this can really turn into something. But I don't know if either of us thought we'd get to this point. Maybe the best season ever by a running back in NFL history.
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Charles, you got to think the number one goal here is ball security. Remember, last drive they caught.
And trying to take possession of the football. That's three picks he's now thrown in his game.
And I know this is holiday season because here we are in December. Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Those corners who can not only cover, but don't mind getting a little physical as well. How about the coverage on that play, knocking that pass away?
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Henry up the middle, looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. See those guys out wide get called for holding on running plays here, passing play.
Yeah, sometimes you get this quick screen, bubble screen, anything where they're having to block for their fellow receiver, usually the point of attack, and this time he got caught.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Here's a play fake as they set up the throw. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. Looks like a 9-yard loss, and it also brings up fourth. Carlson able to put this one through, and the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. Well, Charles, I think you have to call on one for the defense after the turnover already in field goal range, and they had to settle for three.
Yeah, Bean, the beautiful part is you start so close to the end zone that your thought process on offense has to loosen up a little bit because you're thinking to yourself, you're almost guaranteed three. Let's take some good shots at the end zone and try and turn it into six.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Well, this offense trying to change the script here a little bit, CD, trailing on the scoreboard in the last timeout. On the very first play of the drive, they threw that interception.
And you definitely saw his coaches, teammates come over to him on the sideline, trying to help him shake it off, because in this game, his team is down right now. So it's important to make sure you get some confidence back for both the quarterback and the entire offense. Otherwise, those mistakes could continue to pile up.
First down, and they stick with Eckler. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get it behind the line. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Play action. It's gone. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Marcus Williams. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. Well, CD, you know, when you mentioned earlier about spreading the ball around in this game, I don't think you mentioned the guys in the other uniform. With four interceptions here in the first half, and several different guys have picked him off.
Yeah, and instead of analyzing what's going wrong with him, throwing the football, why don't we look at the defense? They came in prepared. An excellent game plan, well scouted, and they're taking it away at almost every turn.
It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. They go play action here on first down. He's got this complete to Robinson. Touchdown, Vikings! Rondell Robinson, his second touchdown of the season. And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the lead now stands at 13. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily to look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage. But you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
He'll get this to Eckler. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. The Lions passing game in sync now. They've got another first down.
is gone.
And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete. I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
Meanwhile, Goff's throw pulled in by Renfro.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 36. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. Now Goff on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
So it looks like this Dawson fighting them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Throwing again is gone.
He dumps it to Eckler underneath.
And able to get this to the 24-yard line. They began the play at the 12. It's also a pickup of 12 for the first down. Shotgun snap for Goff. The open man here, Renfro. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. Called that a very strong gain of 24.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just need the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Now they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass.
On the keeper, here's Goff. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Goff going to keep it himself. And this time he breaks the plane. He's in for the touchdown.
The sneak successful from a yard out. And the Lions have cut it back within a score.
The PAT good. It would draw him closer, but hold on just a second. A flag is down on the field.
And they'll accept that penalty.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield.
This fielded right at the goal line.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. And right side, Henry's got it. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
The Vikings at 12-1 now to start play. They've been flawless these last couple months, winners of 9 in a row.
And let's give them a ton of credit because in a league that's built on any given Sunday, any team can win. To run off this kind of a streak, this kind of a number, that's pretty darn impressive.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
They certainly thought he had an open book beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
The Vikings on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. And he finds Corey Davis.
And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, we used to see him, the guy that you could tell the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, it looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
On the counter, it's Henry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down.
But don't tell any defensive coordinator I played for, but that might be considered a win for both teams because defensively they stopped them short and forced the fourth down. But offensively, they picked up enough yards to give their kicker a better shot if that's what they want to do.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They'll run for it with Henry, and he's not going to get the first. I don't even think he made it back to the line of scrimmage. Derrick Henry denied here on fourth down, and the Lions will take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
Throwing again on second and 10. Goff, quickly a slant to Renfro. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Yeah, come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Third and two, goal. And that will be incomplete.
What the countless hard play. He had no panic in his eyes. Was that throw wide? Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand. Now just where he needed to be to knock it away.
They'll run for it with Eckler. That's a good acceleration there as he's across midfield to the 48-yard line. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. Oh, the defensive side, that is so deflating.
Not only is it deflating, they've got to look in each other's eyes on that side of the ball and take each other's measure.
And now here's another interception. And the Vikings are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. Boy, they get him wet again, Charles. 5 interceptions in this game. You rarely see this, maybe a couple of times in a season, but this deep. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Running from the gun with Henry. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. The yardage numbers for him just keep piling up for his career. He's now toppled, Charles, the 11,000-yard mark.
And just think about that. For most NFL running backs in their career, it feels like if they get to 1,000 yards, they've had a nice little run.
He's over 11,000 yards, probably beyond his wildest dreams.
And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fielded just inside the 20. So possession goes over here on the punt. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Now the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
But no kneeling for them. They decided they weren't going to run out the clock. They decided to take their shot downfield, hoping to either make a connection or a pass interference call. They wanted more points to put on the board.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. They'll lose a couple on what should be the final play of the first half. So we've reached halftime here in Minnesota with the Vikings on top. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half.
Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
All night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Walton. He'll get it inside the 20, and he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Last play, they didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Now they gain almost 40 yards here. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. On the move to his left. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Now a handoff to Henry. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. They'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete. Trying to get their tight end involved finally. That's the first time that they've looked his way. He's kind of been a forgotten man in this offensive scheme.
Yeah, didn't look his way at all in the first half. And I'll bet you the offense coordinator made a note at the half and said, let's get him involved because he could be a big-time playmaker for us.
The kick by Carlson is good, and that will make this a 9-point lead. So three field goals, and he's in now. This last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said to us. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been threes.
Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They started on the ground with Eckler. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And he'll push forward for a couple to the 34.
Now, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
From the gun, here's Goff. Kelce, left side. And he is going to have a Lions first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on third and three. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Eckler now between the tackles. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there on second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and wing in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Now a throw here to his running back. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 45-yard line. Up the middle with Eckler. And down inside the 40 to about the 38. 35 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 31.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown out of the backfield. Now they can throw it down after the loss of one.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
They go ahead and snap it. Gone. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. So they try and not only did they not get the first, they fumbled it away.
That's what makes things go from bad to worse. But I know that everyone's going to pop in on the play. It's like, what are you doing? Why would you go for it there? I think the teams that are convinced that they feel pretty good about their game plan, what they want to get done that day, go for it. Give it a try. Hey, let's see if your defense can rescue him a little bit.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
With his size, it often takes more than one guy to get him down, but if you can at least slow him up and the reinforcements arrive, you have a chance.
throw knocked away and incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'm guaranteeing he quietly has told them, you might all stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
They'll look to throw here.
Offensively, they're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Here's Logan Cook now. He's been terrific so far, averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. 47-yard punt, a return of four. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And right now they're on the wrong end of the scoreboard, and that won't change if this drive ends like the last one when they had that lost fumble. So you have a feeling taking care of the football certainly paramount right now.
Yeah, and it's not just the guy who dropped it on the last drive, is it? That means everyone.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Marcus Williams. And the Vikings will take over possession here up at the 44. Yes, folks, that is his third interception. And I'm going to use one of those overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that. And thus far, they've been successful.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. A dime look defensively for the Lions on third. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
He's second in the NFL in interceptions, and you understand why. He plays a game of great intelligence, understands positioning, and has a great ability to break on the football when it's in the air.
So fun to watch his closing speed, and another example of it on that play. It's a 47-yard punt, return of six. And the Lions are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass. And if I would kept having a rough patch, he said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. Now a play fake, and it's gone. Open man here. It's the tight end, Kelce. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain there of 21 yards. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 42-yard line. A handoff to Tackler. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it, tell them to go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
And now here is another interception. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. The number seven, usually lucky here. And seven picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened six times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw it, he won a Heisman Trophy in college. So sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career. But when you're talking about one game, seven, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw seven picks. We're off to the fourth quarter here in Week 15. Happy holidays to all. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The last run got six. Now second and four. In motion right is Robinson. Henry again on second down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
The offense on third down tonight, they've converted just twice and have had plenty of opportunities. This will be third and six. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. A nice pickup of 23 on the third down conversion.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands they're going to get additional guys running in the quarterback.
Second down and three, ball on the seven. And the busy night for Henry continues. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the six to the five.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
I know this game's winding down and people are getting tired, and that's when you really want a big body guy running the football. But I have to tell you, watching him run it, I wonder why they don't use it more earlier in the game.
Yeah, those bigger guys here late in the game, you're trying to protect the lead, usually not as fumble prone either.
No, that is so true, because they are taught, take care of the ball as you surge forward, and you often see them with both hands wrapped around it when they go through the line.
So stump from the two, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. Looking to throw. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Corey Davis from 3 yards out. And the Vikings add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, second year in the NFL. And I don't know if last year as a rookie, if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him go right in front of him. It's because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were all over that. So he continued to survey the field, picked up another target, delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the second-year quarterback.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And that five-game win streak is ticking away here in the fourth quarter. Just haven't. And my goodness, another interception. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football.
This is one heck of an individual performance we're witnessing. That is now his third interception. And keep in mind, folks, this isn't a safety or a cornerback. This is a linebacker.
Does this feel to you like he's having a flashback? Because a lot of these linebackers we see in the NFL, in high school, they were offensive stars. They touched the football all the time. It's like he said to himself, let's go back and put on the letter jacket and go get the football. How about this one? Three interceptions thus far.
Second down at 7.
A 20th carry now for Derrick Henry. And they'll get to him just inside the 15, even after that strong run we witnessed. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 5.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On 3rd down, Henry. And he'll be stopped well short. Only 2 yards there. 4th and 3. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. That will be their 3rd and final stoppage, as they'll only have the 2-minute warning now remaining. So on 4th down, on comes the Viking kicker, Daniel Carlson, from 28 yards out. The kick by Carlson is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Ultimately, not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the 3 and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there, and trailing big here in this 4th quarter.
So after the sack here, 2nd and 14. Now gone. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10.
Goff's throw here complete to Kelsey.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a 2nd and just a few inches left. Out of the gun. Goff. No hesitations. He'll go right back to Kelsey. And this is going to turn into another 1st down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 42. There's Goff. And now here's another interception. Trey Flowers picks it. And the Vikings are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. Yet another interception. I just had to double-check my math. It's now in between last week and this week.
I just used the calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking yet. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it. And sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
Back to Stevenson on 1st down. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage.
On 2nd down, it's Stevenson. And a good push there defensively as they stop him at the 48. Gain of just 1.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a 3rd down now as they look for 1 more 1st down to help salt this one away. Inside handoff, Henry. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4th.
When this offense gathers to watch the tape, they're going to like a lot of what they saw. They put up big numbers, but they might fast forward through that last play.
Oh, there will be time on the bad plays than you do on the good ones. It's just the nature of coaches. But I know sitting in that room, when you've had a big game, the night that they've had, you don't want to hear that. You just want to focus on the good stuff.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this play.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football. Charles, are you kidding me? Four interceptions? I mean, that's a good season for a lot of defensive backs.
A lot of reason to get voted into the Pro Bowl. When you have 4-1 game, I mean, talk about a campaign slogan, right? I got four. Send me to the Pro Bowl, guys. What a game we've experienced watching this one.
Bobby McCain here, the one who brings him down. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Victory formation time for the Vikings as they'll take a knee here.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for you.
And that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for your kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So the final seconds have ticked away in this Minnesota victory. That was their defensive running over the statement after the break. They pitched the second half short.
Yeah, think about it. The team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the